Thank you, God, for blessing Leo with a clear, concise message from you. Hey, guys, it's me. It's Elle. Thank you for being here. Thank you for liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing. Let's go ahead and get into this. Let's see what's going on for Leo this week. All right, so we got justice. Do the right thing. So some of y'all need to do the right thing. All right. Or the right thing will be done unto you. Maybe you will get a yes answer here. Could be delayed. Could be in regards to maybe some governmental agency or somebody who has to rightfully decide, righteous decision or something here. Yeah. This could even be repayment of debt or debt repaid or karmic debt also. Like, you could be getting what's due unto you. If you put good out, it's coming back to you. What is going on here? The Page of Swords. So again, yes answer, but it's delayed. It could come in 1 to 11 days. You could be the subject of gossip. People are talking about you. Pettiness is, you know, it's nothing. It's lightweight. It's haters. With the Page of Swords here, it says don't be engaged in gossip too. You could be a little bit too gossipy at this time. Someone is inquiring about you, asking about you, with the Page of Swords, maybe even looking you up or trying to look you up here. This is a need to be more tactful, tasteful, graceful in your communication. You could be a little too harsh. You say things and, you know, you need to kind of reel it in or find another way to say it. I see. The Two of Swords. Yeah. So what you say leads to disharmony, disruption. People actually not liking you. If you're okay with that, keep it up. The Two of Swords also, it talks about maybe something being reconciled. So we're going to look over the account and then we're going to reconcile it and make it right or make it make sense. True reconciliation is confessing your shortcomings to one another. And that's all reconciling is. If you reconcile your bank account, then you're looking over the numbers to see, hell, if there are any shortcomings or, you know, if there were any double charges or, and in terms of a relationship, you look over the relationship, you just, you know, trying to see if there are any shortcomings in the relationship, maybe from you or from your person, or was there any double talk? Was there any, you know, not fulfilling, you know, promise? So it's like, if you want to come back together with somebody, if you want this to last, y'all got to really, you know, confess your shortcomings to one another. That's true reconciliation. We hear the word reconciliation so many times in the tarot. Some of you could be looking at the tarot a lot in the tarot readings, and we just say, oh, okay, that means they're coming back. I don't know. They could come back. Y'all could say two words to each other, and then it's, you know, an all-out brawl, or it's just don't ever talk to me again. So reconciliation is a process, though. It's a process of going over what the past looks like, and then in hopes that we can make some determination of what our future should look like. So it's a conversation. It's a coming to, it's a leveling. You know, let's level with one another. Let's reason. So when you hear that word, think of that. You have to have a conversation about reason and leveling with one another and being honest about where you fall short and where they fall short. Okay. Three of Wands, someone is expecting your phone call, your reaching out, your text message. If you want to make this work, y'all both need to be honest about, like, okay, well, I'm not good at that. I'm not good at communicating. Sometimes I am too emotional. Maybe I do blow up and whatever. The Three of Wands, somebody has to take the lead in terms of communicating. Be the leader here, leadership role. See the long view of this. It's the only way you're going to let the ego subside and you're going to initiate. Get to initiate. Get three initiation cards. This is all initiation. That reduces to a two. This is, could be a one. We've got two and three. So it's definitely that somebody needs to initiate here. This who? Which side? You or your person who's going to initiate and talk? Five of Swords. Learn how to get through the tough times, not run from the tough times or run from each other during the tough times. Learn how to see through in the face of adversity, in the face of change, in the face of reversal, in the face of, you know, heavy argument. Sharpen your words. Mean what you say. Say what you mean. Even if there's bad blood between the two of you, you still can have respect. Learn how to fight. You know, because you will fight in relationship, romantic, familiar, business, but learn how to fight. Because some things you can't come back from with the Five of Swords. All right, let's see. What else we got going on here? This is all like a relationship. Ten of Wands, something is becoming a little bit burdensome here. It says don't give up before, you know, the big break, before it, the breakthrough, before something actually breaks. It says, you know, this is like break down and then break through. Something has to break down. Somebody's got a big wall up here. Somebody doesn't want to let the other in. Someone's taking the relationship or the other person for granted. Don't do that. Everybody plays a part. Everybody is valuable in some sense. It could be that some people are more valuable. Some are, you know, less, but everybody's valuable. You know, so don't take people for granted. Four of Pentacles. Yeah, somebody's got a definite wall up from, you know, maybe some deep-seated issues from the past. Childhood trauma, wounds. Somebody's feeling like they want to go it alone. The Four of Pentacles, someone's feeling like this is a toxic, stuck, clingy-ass relationship where somebody is possessive, jealous, domineering, and they're ruling. They're trying to rule from a place of fear and lack. You know, I fear that my person might have their own mind and leave me and think, you know, better of someone else and leave me. Or I fear that I have to stay on top, or I can't let them view me as their equal. Or this is his fear, the Empress card. There's somebody here who's open and there's somebody's closed. Somebody's made their determination. It could be a masculine energy. Somebody's really after their short-term goals, whatever it is they're trying to accomplish. They're really for self right now, and communication is breaking down. It's miscommunication, it's misinterpretation, it's just drama, it's argument, it's maybe even third party situation. It doesn't have to be a loved one. I mean, a romantic partner. It can be anybody. It could be anything that comes in between. That third party could be anything. The Nine of Swords. Somebody's feeling like, is this the end? Is this really the end? Because we keep having circular arguments. Like, we keep having arguments that have historical value. Like, we argued about this last week. We argued about this last month. It's because you aren't really dealing with it. It says break it down. And in the rubble, maybe you guys can rebuild or go your separate ways. But you're going to keep having the same argument because you're not really dealing with it. What's the advice? See the bigger picture. King of Wands, that's the advice. Somebody's tied to the home. Listen to your psychic nudges. There's luck associated with this. You do have options. And put yourself out there, but see the bigger picture, you know, whatever that means to you. Knight of Wands, somebody said the universe might be telling you, put yourself out there, go in the world, see what the world has to offer you. Six of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles, yet go in the world. You got to go your own way, take your power back. Six of Pentacles, let the power dynamic change, shift. You may be waiting for someone to give you something, to give you love, to give you affection, to give you time, to give you attention, to give you energy. Let it change. Let the power dynamic change to where someone is waiting for you to do that, or it's mutual. But right now, you can't be in a place of just waiting to be fed. You might have to be Nine of Pentacles, independent. Do your own thing and be concerned about self and not the relationship, because somebody here is extremely concerned about self. This is what I have for you, Leo. If it resonates, let me know how it resonates down in the comments section. Go over to the website, book your own reading there. Ask 8 questions or 10 by texting them to the number below. You can also catch me live every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday night, 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Thank you guys. Many blessings to you. Take care.